Law Office of Flywheel, Shyster and Flywheel. No, Mr. Flywheel isn't in yet. He's in court. Thank you. Flywheel, Shyster and Flywheel. No, Mr. Flywheel's in court. I expect him at any minute. All right. Good morning, Mr. Flywheel.
Never mind that. Get President Hoover on the phone. There's a picture of me in the police station and it doesn't do me justice. This makes me look like my father. In fact, it is my father. Never mind calling the president, just find out what the reward is.
Mr. Flywheel, I have some letters for you to sign. Not now, not now. I had a big day in court.
What's the case? Disorderly conduct, but I think I'll get off. Why shouldn't I? She hit me first.
Mr. Flywheel, you hit a woman?
Well, she was my size, even smaller. Besides, if it weren't for my own arrests, I'd never get a case. Any calls?
Yes, your creditors have been calling all morning. They said they've tired of phoning and they want something else to be done.
All right, we'll do something. I'll take the telephone out.
Okay.
There's a good girl. Your salary is raised to $10.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Flywheel.
Nothing at all.
Say, how about lending me that 10 till payday? But Mr. Flywheel, I haven't been paid in weeks. Besides, you overlooked the fact—
I've overlooked plenty around here. A fine stenographer you are. What do you do with your time? The floors aren't washed, the windows aren't cleaned, and my pants aren't even pressed.
But Mr. Flywheel—
Enough of this small talk. Where's that $10?
I haven't a penny.
Who was asking for a penny? If I wanted a penny, I would go right to my baby's bank. If I had a baby. I'm going to my office now. If the phone rings, don't answer it. It may be a wrong number.
Come in.
Hello, my name's Emmanuel Ravielli. Is the boss in?
Oh, he's busy. Have you got a card?
Sure, but I can take another one. I want to see the boss.
Well, what do you want to see him about?
Well, you see, I want to get a divorce.
Mr. Flywheel's a very busy man. I'll have to fill out a report. You want a divorce? Let's see. Any children?
Sure, maybe 6 or 7. I don't see very well. Wait, let me see. There's a Tony, there's a Jose, there's a Pascal, there's an Angelino, there's a Jake. No Jake. Jake, that's the kid next door. See, you got them all mixed up. And then we got a new little baby.
A new little baby? Is it a boy or a girl?
I don't know, he no speak yet.
How long have you been married?
Oh, no, lady, I am not married. My brother, he's married.
Oh, he wants a divorce.
No, he don't want a divorce. He like his wife. He's happy, but I think he's a bit crazy.
You mean you want him to divorce your wife because you don't like her?
No, I like her. I like her. She's a nicer girl. But I, she's not a very good cook.
Does your brother complain?
Oh, no, he don't complain. He's satisfied. He eat out.
Well, why don't you eat out?
See, I can't afford it. I got no job.
All right, why don't you get a job?
All right, forget the divorce. I take the job.
I'll have to speak with Mr. Flywheel. Where can I get a hold of you?
No, lady, you see, I'm very ticklish.
I mean, where do you live?
I live with my brother. Just take a seat. I'll call Mr. Flywheel. Mr. Flywheel!
Well, did you get that $10 or what?
No. There's a man out here who wants to talk to you about a job.
Alright, I'll take the job, but I'm only working for $20. Nothing more, nothing less.
You misunderstand. He wants a job here. Oh, he wants a job. I think I can put him to work.
Oh no, I don't want to work. I just want a job.
How about references?
Oh, that's alright. You no need references. I like your face. And I like your face. If it is a face.
Say, you look exactly like a fellow I used to know. His name was Emmanuel Ravielli. Are you his brother?
I am Emmanuel Ravielli.
You're Emmanuel Ravielli?
I'm Emmanuel Ravielli.
No wonder you look like him, but I still insist there's a resemblance. Hey, we no speak about money. Suits me fine. If you promise not to say anything about it, I won't mention it either.
Alright, but I gotta have more money.
I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you $6 a week if you bring your own lunches.
Well,
I'll go one further than that. I'll give you $6 a week, and you can bring me lunch, too.
$6 a week.
Hey, boss, I can't live on $6 a week.
You can't live on $6 a week. That'll make me very happy. You're hired.
When do I start?
Well, it's 1 o'clock right now. If you start now, you can be back here by 3 with a lunch. You can bring me a tomato sandwich with white bread.
I got no white bread, but I can give you a rye.
All right, I'll take a quarter rye.
Sorry, but I'm wearing them.
You're wearing a quarter rye?
Yeah, my quarter rye pants.
Say, why don't you get double pneumonia?
I don't need it, I'm a single man. Besides, I gotta have more money.
Have you any experience?
You bet. For 15 years, I'm a musician.
What do you get an hour?
Well, for playing, I get $10 an hour.
What do you get for not playing?
$12.
Now that's more like it.
Now, for rehearsing, I make a special rate. $15 an hour.
What do you get for not rehearsing?
Oh, you couldn't afford it.
See, if I no rehearse, I no play. And if I no play, that runs into money.
What would you want to run into an open manhole?
Just drop the cover charge.
Well, drop in sometime.
Sure. Well, I guess we clean that up.
No, we no clean that up.
Now, let's see how we stand. Yesterday, I didn't come. That cost you $15. Today, I did come. That's $20 you owe me. Tomorrow, I leave. That's worth about $1 million, but let's not quibble over money. I offer you $6. I'll raise you 2. If you raise me 2, I raise you 3.
I'll call you. What you got?
I got raises up. What you got? I had a notion to throw you out of my office.
Alright, I'll take it.
Flywheel, Shyster, and Flywheel. Oh, hello, Charlie. Call me back. Someone's coming in.
My name is T. Edgar Jones. I want to see Mr. Flywheel.
He's in his office. Walk right in.
Thank you.
Ah, hello. How do you do, Mr. Flywheel?
A friend of mine told you you were a good lawyer.
You think he's a friend of yours? Sit down. You got a couple of cigars?
No, I'm sorry.
Well, why don't you send for some? If you got a quarter on you, I'll go myself.
Oh, no, Mr. Flywheel.
What's the matter? You don't trust me?
Why, I'd like to talk with you. I'm having trouble with my wife.
You are? I'm having trouble with my wife, too, but you don't see me bragging about it.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Mrs. Dimple, show this gentleman the door.
On second thought, never mind the door. He probably saw it when he came in.
But, Mr. Flywheel, I came to you for advice. Let me tell you a story. My wife is in love with two men.
Not a bad story. The boys are repeating it all around the club.
Now, let me tell you one. There were two traveling men named Pat and Mike.
No, Mr. Flywheel. I came here with a problem.
Well, why didn't you bring her in?
You don't understand. I'm looking for evidence against my wife.
Well, why didn't you say so? Well, let me look in my law book. Here we are.
Here we are. The case of Emry T. Gribble against the Lee and Western Railroad. Of course, the Lee is just a short road. It's only Lee to a grasshopper.
But Mr. Flywheel,
that's a railroad law book.
Well, what's wrong with it? It's got 800 pages and it's clean as a whistle. If I had a whistle, I'd show you.
But I'm suing my wife.
Is that any reason why I have to get another law book?
Why don't you sue a railroad? A railroad's got more money than your wife. Besides, the railroad won't ask for alimony.
Please, Mr. Flywheel, I don't want to argue. I'm tired, nervous, run down.
Run down!
Say, now we've got a case. Were you run down by a railroad?
Mr. Flywheel, you try my patience.
I don't mind if I do. You must come over and try some of mine. I'm putting up a new batch.
Batch? What batch?
Batch on my pants. Some joke, ain't it? But that's mere trifle. As I understand it, what you really want is for someone to shadow your wife.
I got just the man for you.
My new assistant, Emmanuel Ravielli.
He may talk like an idiot and look like an idiot, but don't let that fool you. He really is an idiot. You and Ravioli have a lot in common. Mr. Flywheel, my time is valuable. Let me give you the facts. I married my wife secretly. You married her secretly? And you still haven't told her? No wonder she runs around with other men. Mr. Flywheel, we must get this divorce. I want your assistant, Mr. Ravioli, to follow my wife.
One thing at a time, sir. Let's get the divorce first, and then we can all follow your wife.
I don't quite understand the proceedings, Mr. Flywheel, but I leave everything in your hands. You're the doctor.
I'm the doctor? Good, I'll take out your tonsils on Monday. I'll take your wife out on Tuesday. On Wednesday,
just a minute, Mr. Flywheel.
Dr. Flywheel to you. Stick out your tongue and come back next Wednesday.
Just get your assistant. I want to give him a description of my wife.
Very well then, Mr. Jones, if that's the way you feel about it, I'll call him.
Ravioli! Ravioli!
Miss Dimple, wake up Ravioli. Miss Dimple, will you wake up Ravioli?
Mr. Jones, will you go on and wake up Miss Dimple and leave a call for me at 9?
Here I am, boss. You calling Ravioli?
See here, I don't like you sleeping on the company's time.
I don't like sleeping on it either. Why don't you give me a bed?
Mr. Ravioli, I want you to meet Mr. Jones.
All right, where do I meet him?
Mr. Ravioli, I am very happy to make your acquaintance.
I don't know what he's talking about.
He means he's very happy to see you,
but he's probably crazy.
Mr. Ravioli, I've just been telling Mr. Flywheel that, as much as I regret to say it, my wife is not all that she should be. I think she's going around with other men.
She's going around with other men? That's a fine name. Hey,
you think she's liking me?
I can see you two boys have a lot to talk over. Besides, I have a director's meeting across the street in the pool room, so if you'll excuse me, I'll scram.
Pool room? Mr. Flywheel, it strikes me that things aren't done in a very business-like way here. In the middle of a conference, you go out to play pool.
Hey, I've gotta go. There's no pool room in here.
Well, Mr. Ravioli, as long as you're going to trail my wife, I think I ought to describe her to you. She's of medium height and, No, but never mind. I got a photograph of my wife with me. Ah, here you are, Mr. Ravioli.
Hey, that's a fine. All right, I take a dozen.
I'm not selling them. You mean I get it for nothing?
Of course. All right, I take a 2 dozen.
One picture, it will be enough for the present. Now then, Mr. Ravioli, there's one man my wife is paying particular attention to. I'm counting on you to find out who he is. Do you think you can do it?
Sure, you lean with me. I find out who that man is with your wife, and I find out quick.
Really? How are you going to do it?
Well, first I put on a disguise, yes? Then I get a bloodhound, yes? Then I go over to your house, yes? And then I ask her your wife.
Law Officer Flywheel, Shyster, and Flywheel.
No, Mr. Flywheel isn't in yet, but I expect him at any moment.
Oh, hello, Mr. Jones. I didn't recognize your voice. Yes, Mr. Ravioli is still trailing your wife, but it hasn't been long, just 2 weeks. We expect Mr. Ravioli in the office this morning. He says he has some news. Okay, I'll tell Mr. Flywheel you'll be in. Goodbye.
Good morning, Mr. Flywheel.
Quick, get Warburton, McAllister, Throckmorton, and Bruce on the phone and ask for Mr. Schwartz. Tell him I want to borrow a pair of socks.
Borrow a pair of socks?
Why not? When he came to me, I gave him the very shirt off my back. Of course, it happened to be his shirt, but the cuffs were mine. Any new clients, Miss Dimple?
No, sir.
No clients. Whenever I leave you in charge, there's no business. Yesterday, I snuck around, and look what happened. We had a big day.
Yesterday was a big day?
Certainly. Didn't I sell the carpet?
Why, and Miss Dimple, before I forget, call Ravioli and tell him to be sure and oversleep.
But he phoned and said he was coming right in.
In that case, I'm going right back to the ballroom.
But Mr. Jones was on his way here to talk to you about his divorce.
That's all he ever talks about to me. I'm getting pretty sick of it too.
But Mr. Flywheel, that's your business.
Well, I wish he'd keep his nose out of my business.
Shh, someone's coming. I think it's Mr. Jones.
How do you do, Mr. Jones?
How do you do, Miss Dimple?
Good morning, Mr. Flywheel. About my divorce.
Divorce! Oh, here you go, getting started with that again. Where was it? It has to be somewhere. Give me a minute. Here it is. It's a ticket to the Fireman's Ball. It's a $5 ticket, and it's yours for a buck and a half.
Why?
This is last year's ticket.
I know, but they had a better show last year.
Mr. Flywheel, when will I find out about my case?
See here, Jones, don't change the subject. What about your ticket?
I don't like to appear impatient, Mr. Flywheel, but your assistant was supposed to bring some evidence against my wife. Where is Ravioli?
Hey, who's calling Ravioli? Here I am.
Ah, Mr. Ravioli. I'd like to get the results of your investigation. Have you been trailing my wife?
Sure, just like a bloodhound. Hey, you remember when you gave me a picture of your wife?
Yes?
Well, I start up. Just like a bloodhound, I tell you. And in 1 hour. Even less than 1 hour.
Yes?
I lose the picture.
Well, there you are, Jones. He did all that in only 1 hour.
Then you didn't shadow my wife, Ravioli.
Oh, sure, I shadow her all day.
Well, what day was that?
Saturday. That was some joke, eh, boss?
Well, I went right to your house. What did you find?
I found your wife out.
Then you wasted the entire 2 weeks?
Oh, no. Monday, I shadow your wife. Tuesday, I go to the ball game. She no show up. Wednesday, she go to the ball game. I no show up. Thursday was a doubleheader. We both no show up. Friday, it rained all day, so there was a no game, so I went fishing.
Well, then what's that got to do with my wife?
Well, I'm not catching no fish, but I catch your wife.
You caught my wife? With a man?
Sure.
Who was he?
I don't want to say.
I insist you tell me the man's name. I don't want to tell.
Listen, Jones. My assassin isn't the type of fellow who'd bandy a man's good name in public.
For the last time, who was the man?
Okay, come clean, Ravioli. Who was the man with his wife? All right, you're making me tell, I tell you. Mr. Jones, the man with your wife was my boss, Mr. Flywheel.
This is an outrage! My attorney is going out with my wife.
What do you mean an outrage? You think I'm not good enough for her?
I'm going to see another attorney.
I suppose you think we can't get a new client?
Good day, sir.
Ravioli, you did noble work. You can have the rest of the year off, and if you never come back again, I'll give you a bonus.
Well, boss, there's something I want to tell you.
Go right ahead, I'm not listening.
You want I should never come back?
In a word, yes.
Alright, boss, I'm making you a proposition. If you want I should never come back, I gotta have more money.
Ravioli, it's worth it.